one petroleum company and the lubricant leader with GP Petroleums, the erstwhile Shah Petroleum, for marketing the Repsol range of lubricants in India. We are very, very happy to, you can say, commit to the Repsol brand of lubricants, fully blended in India and marketed by GP Petroleums in India starting today. Repsol has been a leader of two-wheeler segment thanks to the association with Honda engine manufacturers, for one of the longest associations in the lubricant and engine manufacturer relationship. They have been leaders in the track, and whatever technology they have been using in the track has been now brought to the Indian market. GP Petroleums basically used to be known as Sa Petroleum in India. We had the brand called IPOL, which was a very focused industrial lubricant brand, which contributed more than 90% of the company's volume. Any big lubricant company needs a balance of 50% of automotive, 50% of industrial range of lubes. We had a choice of either trying to bring the IPOL range of lubricants, spend a lot of time, money, energy to develop the full range of IPOL range of lubricants with R&D backup, or to get a good established brand with a very strong R&D and lubricant technology. And we went for the second option. We found a very good partner in Repsol, who were leaders in the technology space of engine lubrication, and we tied up with Repsol. And that way, we were able to, you can say, cut short a lot of time and energy to bring the range of world-class lubricants into India. Thanks to the teams of Repsol and GP Petroleum working together the last 7 to 8 months, now we have the products blended in India and ready for the market. Today we'll be launching the lubricants in Mumbai, and day after we'll be launching the Repsol range of lubricants in Jaipur, and we'll be slowly and steadily expanding our range to cover the full automotive segment. Thanks for your presence to get this announcement out into the market. And it's a great day for both our organizations. Repsol has been trying to come into India for quite a few years, and it's a great synergy between two companies who want to do the same thing. Enter India, the third largest lubricant market in the world, and establish the range of lubricants. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Panapandian.
Sit back and say, the day has ultimately come. It's a very exciting day for all of us in the Kraft Petrochem Group, and more particularly in GP Petroleums Limited, which is a listed company in India. What we are looking forward to is the exciting Repsol brand being manufactured in India and also sold in India. So what do we do differently here? The question always comes up, there are so many people in India selling lubricants, so what's different? I just would like to recall that just the day before in Argentina, if you see the MotoGP, the Honda Repsol team was leading and winning. And now it's the product of lubricant that's being used in such endurance tests as a racetrack. We will be bringing it to our people in India. So this is a product which is actually of a very high order of endurance and quality, which we are bringing it, making it in India and also marketing in India. Now, how are we going to do that? We are actually looking at a completely different way of looking at the market. We will be positioning Repsol into a premium segment. We will be looking at Repsol to start with the two-wheeler and then get into the passenger car and the heavy trucks market. This is quite an exciting day for us where we first lay the stones and make it happen in today. About a few months before, as Tanga mentioned, we laid the stones of partnership, and I think the fruitful day has come today. We are looking forward to the market with a lot of enthusiasm, and I'm sure the consumers in the Indian market will welcome a high quality product which can actually be of use for the consumer as well.
Thank you, Mr. Hari Prakash. I'm sure a lot of people who are advised will look forward to high action on the roads once Repsol is launched in India. Can we now have a Repsol perspective? May I ask Mr. Pascal to give us a perspective on that, what Repsol will do in India?
I'm supposed to introduce the company, so let me stand up and to, you know. Can you hear me? Well,